Hello, my name's Norman Pace. You might have seen me before with my comedy partner, Gareth Hale. Now, as anyone will tell you, one of the most important things about comedy is timing. Well, let me tell you a story about the importance of timing. This story is about a little girl called Holly. Holly was just 4.5 weeks old. One day, she didn't seem to be her normal self. She didn't seem to have her normal energy. Her mum and dad were a little worried, but Holly didn't seem too unwell. They'd heard about meningitis, but didn't really know too much about it.
Meningitis and septicemia are diseases that can affect anyone and can have devastating results. Meningitis is caused when the meninges, the lining around the brain and spinal cord, are inflamed. Septicemia is blood poisoning caused by the same bacteria that cause meningitis. The important thing to remember is that time is absolutely crucial. The faster someone can be treated, the better chance they have of surviving and making a good recovery.
Holly's mum and dad took her with them when they went to the supermarket. She'd been pale and quiet for some time. Then she started vomiting violently and refused any more food. They began to think something was seriously wrong. But even then, they had no idea she was showing the symptoms of meningitis.
Meningitis and septicemia usually start with flu-like symptoms, such as fever and vomiting, and feeling tired and unwell. If someone has meningitis and septicemia, they'll become very ill very quickly. Other symptoms include shivering, rapid breathing, cold hands and feet, joint and muscle pain, stomach pain, sometimes with diarrhea, drowsiness and confusion, severe headache, a stiff neck, a dislike of bright lights, and a rash anywhere on the body. Remember that these symptoms may appear in any order, and some may not appear at all. You can have septicemia without any of the meningitis symptoms.
By this time, Holly's parents were deeply concerned. They phoned their GP. She came immediately and sent them straight to hospital. They were worried and confused. Well, they didn't know what was waiting for them at the other end.
Meningitis and septicemia can affect anyone of any age, but most cases are in babies, young children, and teenagers. Some of these symptoms are harder to notice in babies because they can't tell you how they're feeling. But there are specific baby symptoms, like a tense or bulging soft spot on the head, blotchy skin that gets paler or turns blue, refusing to feed, being irritable when picked up with a high-pitched or moaning cry, a stiff body with jerky movements, or else being floppy and lifeless. The rash may not appear right away either, but if someone has a rash, here's an easy way to check if it's a meningitis rash. Take an ordinary glass tumbler and press it onto the rash. If the rash doesn't fade and you can clearly see it through the glass tumbler, get medical help immediately. In its early stages, the rash might fade, so keep checking. The rash can be harder to see on dark skin, so check for spots over the whole body, especially on paler areas like the palms of the hands, the soles of the feet, and the abdomen. Also check inside the eyelids and the roof of the mouth.
When they finally reached the hospital, Holly was examined straight away. Holly's mum and dad were told it was meningitis. One doctor even explained which type of meningitis it was, but Holly's parents didn't know one type from another.
The two main types of meningitis are viral and bacterial. Although viral meningitis can be very nasty, it's not normally life-threatening, and most people will soon make a full recovery. But bacterial meningitis and septicemia can kill in hours and can cause disabilities like deafness, brain damage, and the need for amputations. Vaccines provide excellent protection against some forms of meningitis and septicemia, but can't protect against all of them.
Now all they could do was sit and wait. Ironically, each minute now seemed to drag on for hours. Even though their case is typical of so many families, they couldn't help blaming themselves. Could they have reacted faster? Like so many parents, they'd been fooled by Holly's apparent lack of distress in the early stages.
Parents know their children better than anybody else, so trust your instincts. Whether or not there's a rash, if someone is seriously ill and getting worse fast, they will need medical help. The sooner these diseases are recognised and treated, the better the chances of making a good recovery. That's why it's important to know the symptoms of meningitis and septicemia.
This story does not have a completely happy ending, I'm afraid. Thanks to the skill of the medical staff, Holly survived, but she's partially paralyzed down her left side. And although she's doing well at school and achieving many things in her life, Holly will never be truly independent. Even though Holly's mum and dad reacted just like any parents in the same situation, they can't help feeling they could have picked up the warning signs faster. They've often thought, would things have been different if they got Holly to hospital sooner? I should know. I'm Holly's dad.
I'm very happy to be in this video with my dad because it might help save the lives of other children with meningitis and septicemia.
Meningitis and septicemia are uncommon, but don't keep thinking it couldn't happen to you. It could happen to anyone. It happened to us. Make sure you know all the symptoms. Make sure you react straight away if you spot the symptoms. Every minute can make the difference, so please make sure you get up to speed with meningitis. Right, Hol? If you're worried about someone who's ill, or just want information about symptoms, call Meningitis Research Foundation's free phone 24-hour helpline. Tell them the number, Hol.
080-8800-344.
Say it again, babe.
080-8800-344.
Give me five. All right.
Meningitis Research Foundation is a national registered charity whose vision is a world free from meningitis and septicemia. The charity is fighting these diseases by funding vital scientific research, raising awareness of the symptoms, and providing help and support to people who have been affected. But this vital work takes money. If you can make a donation or help raise the money needed, please contact the foundation.
Hello, my name's Norman Pace. You might have seen me before with my comedy partner, Gareth Hale. Now, as anyone will tell you, one of the most important things about comedy is timing. Well, let me tell you a story about the importance of timing. This story is about a little girl called Holly. Holly was just 4.5 weeks old. One day, she didn't seem to be her normal self. She didn't seem to have her normal energy. Her mum and dad were a little worried, but Holly didn't seem too unwell. They'd heard about meningitis, but didn't really know too much about it.
Meningitis and septicemia are diseases that can affect anyone and can have devastating results. Meningitis is caused when the meninges, the lining around the brain and spinal cord, are inflamed. Septicemia is blood poisoning caused by the same bacteria that cause meningitis. The important thing to remember is that time is absolutely crucial. The faster someone can be treated, the better chance they have of surviving and making a good recovery.
Holly's mum and dad took her with them when they went to the supermarket. She'd been pale and quiet for some time. Then she started vomiting violently and refused any more food. They began to think something was seriously wrong. But even then, they had no idea she was showing the symptoms of meningitis.
Meningitis and septicemia usually start with flu-like symptoms, such as fever and vomiting, and feeling tired and unwell. If someone has meningitis and septicemia, they'll become very ill very quickly. Other symptoms include shivering, rapid breathing, cold hands and feet, joint and muscle pain, stomach pain, sometimes with diarrhea, drowsiness and confusion, severe headache, a stiff neck, a dislike of bright lights, and a rash anywhere on the body. Remember that these symptoms may appear in any order, and some may not appear at all. You can have septicemia without any of the meningitis symptoms.
By this time, Holly's parents were deeply concerned. They phoned their GP. She came immediately and sent them straight to hospital. They were worried and confused. Well, they didn't know what was waiting for them at the other end.
Meningitis and septicemia can affect anyone of any age, but most cases are in babies, young children, and teenagers. Some of these symptoms are harder to notice in babies because they can't tell you how they're feeling. But there are specific baby symptoms, like a tense or bulging soft spot on the head, blotchy skin that gets paler or turns blue, refusing to feed, being irritable when picked up with a high-pitched or moaning cry, a stiff body with jerky movements, or else being floppy and lifeless. The rash may not appear right away either, but if someone has a rash, here's an easy way to check if it's a meningitis rash. Take an ordinary glass tumbler and press it onto the rash. If the rash doesn't fade and you can clearly see it through the glass tumbler, get medical help immediately. In its early stages, the rash might fade, so keep checking. The rash can be harder to see on dark skin, so check for spots over the whole body, especially on paler areas like the palms of the hands, the soles of the feet, and the abdomen. Also check inside the eyelids and the roof of the mouth.
When they finally reached the hospital, Holly was examined straight away. Holly's mum and dad were told it was meningitis. One doctor even explained which type of meningitis it was, but Holly's parents didn't know one type from another.
The two main types of meningitis are viral and bacterial. Although viral meningitis can be very nasty, it's not normally life-threatening, and most people will soon make a full recovery. But bacterial meningitis and septicemia can kill in hours and can cause disabilities like deafness, brain damage, and the need for amputations. Vaccines provide excellent protection against some forms of meningitis and septicemia, but can't protect against all of them.
Now all they could do was sit and wait. Ironically, each minute now seemed to drag on for hours. Even though their case is typical of so many families, they couldn't help blaming themselves. Could they have reacted faster? Like so many parents, they'd been fooled by Holly's apparent lack of distress in the early stages.
Parents know their children better than anybody else, so trust your instincts. Whether or not there's a rash, if someone is seriously ill and getting worse fast, they will need medical help. The sooner these diseases are recognised and treated, the better the chances of making a good recovery.